so, oh my God. That's how the crappie should eat it. I stopped it, whack. That's a big guy too, man. I see him fighting from here, look at this. How's that? That's a crankbait slab right there, boy. That's what I'm talking about right there. As soon as you stop it, you find the weeds, guess what you find? Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This week I got something a little bit different. It's called Slab Wars. Epic battles of big black crappie versus white crappie. Which ones are more fun to catch? Which ones taste better? Which ones are scrap harder? Which ones are more versatile and different? Or which ones can adapt to different conditions? You name it. One thing about crappie fishing, it doesn't matter if they're black or they're white. They're just as exciting to catch. And the thing about fishing in the deep south, which I've been very fortunate to do, they've got a majority of those big, beautiful white slabs, and you just never know when the next hook set is a 3+ pound white crappie. That's the one thing I'll give the white crappie over the black, is there's always potential for the great big white hubcaps. But in this special episode, it's about some of the fantastic road trips across Ontario, the southern United States, the northern United States, fishing with some fantastic crappie fishermen. So I want you to experience some of the epic battles that we've had fishing for white crappie and black crappie. On this first segment, it is incredible. Fishing with my buddy Tim in a cold front in February sometime on Lake Washington in Mississippi. And man, it was fantastic weather the week before. He caught all kinds of nice crappies. He set the guys that he knew up there. We get there, it's cold front, but Tim's always got a way to figure out how to find them, how to catch them, and put those real big ones in the boat. Check it out.
You know, we got to Lake Washington, was in pre-spawn. I knew the fish hadn't spawned yet. So, you know, we wasn't gonna be fishing really shallow, like a foot or two. I knew we was gonna back off, and we did. We started fishing, and we found the fish actually holding in about 8 to 9 foot of water. And once we really got concentrated in the area, about 100-yard stretch where these big females were pre-spawned in a holding pattern, we really started catching some big ones. We're just gonna set up a slow drill, drift up through here with these quarter ounce jigs. We'll try different colors and we'll see which one they bite, and then we can go to, you know, we figured out we'll go to one color. Right now we're, you know, it's early in the morning. We've had a cold front come through, so we're just kind of experimenting. See which one they want to bite.
Get it. Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah.
He's a monster.
Look at him.
Get the net. Get him in the net, baby. Oh, I can't get him. I can't get him. Oh, yeah.
Hey. Whoa.
Look
at that crappie.
Look at that, baby.
Oh, my goodness, Tim. That's a big one, isn't it?
Made up for it. Look what a fish. Yes. He's mad too.
Yes. Got him in a good spot too, eh? Mm-hmm. There's out. Thank you, sir. Put that back in here. He was mad.
Look
at that,
fish.
Eh?
Man.
Man, oh man. Now you know why I come to Mississippi. I can't beat it, man. Tim, another female, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, we'll take some pictures, like you said. Let these beauties go. They can go back and make some more babies. Oh, Lordy. Wow, look at the thickness of that back. Look at that. It's almost like a bass. Look at it. Big mouth on him. Pulling that minnow. But I was lucky. I got him in the hard spot.
You know, once we got dialed in, we found this 100-yard stretch that was holding these big sows getting ready to spawn. And we had to concentrate on that area, and it was a certain speed, you know, 0.3 on my GPS is where these fish were triggering the bite. So we had to concentrate on staying at that speed, and if it wasn't for those power poles and those paddles, it had been real difficult on a windy day when the wind was blowing 20 to 25 mile an hour.
Good one?
No. Boy, he's a fighter, though.
Man, look at him cut up. Man, he's mad. Come on here, Jimbo. Get in the daggum net. Man, he was mad.
Still a good crappie, man. Look at that thing. You know, we're getting spoiled, because look at that. So, like, I thought it was all right. He eat it, he gobbled it. Oh, my goodness.
He eat that.
Look at this. Show that right inside there, Tim.
You know, we were looking for big fish and big bites, and that just goes along. We're catching big fish. You're going to miss some of them.
Yep. Hunting down the big ones. And it's worth it, you know?
You know, just like the .2 to .3 speed, I mean, you got to find those little tricks that makes a difference in your technique and the guy next to you is just trolling, you know, keeping a steady speed to say 0.5 or 0.4.
Yeah.
Today it was just that little trigger that when we stopped and when we took off and reached that speed, it triggered that bite immediately.
Yes. Oh, big one.
Oh.
Oh, boy. Tim, look at the size of this thing.
Don't lose it. Yo, baby.
Uh-oh. That's going to push 3 pounds, baby.
Come on.
Really? 3 pounds.
Oh, my goodness, man.
It's going to push it.
The line went screaming, Tim. Screaming. Like, oh, man. You got these custom jigs. They are a killer. Look at that. He was never coming out, was he? Oh, wow. Let's put that away over here. Let's have a look at the slab. Tim, you know what, buddy? I've been watching you raise your lines up a bit, and I raised that up. Look at that. Seriously, how
That's
big is
sick.
That crappie?
That's sick.
Hey.
Man, wasn't that fun? Beautiful, big, white crappies. But as the next segment, spring day, raining, windy, etc. But man, I just got up to the lake and I wanted to go fishing. So I knew there was a rock pile with some weeds around it and stuff. And I didn't want to just throw the float, you know, with the wind conditions and things. I want to try to find some different crappie, maybe roaming around near the rocks, near the weeds and stuff. So I picked up a small little blade bait with a little plastic curly tail, tossed it around with my special B&M light action, just looking for crappies. And man, oh man, did I have an afternoon of big, beautiful, hard-fighting black crappie. Some of them hit right by the boat, but some of them put a huge bend, man, in that B&M. You talk about tough. Something about that cold water in the north in springtime. When those crappies get hooked, man, oh man, they pull. And at first you think, maybe you got an early season bass. Not the case. These big, big, beautiful black crappie had to be netted. They were provided me a whole afternoon of joy. So sometimes when you get to your favorite lakes, if it's safe to go and it's raining, drizzle, a little bit of wind, maybe some sleet and snow, it doesn't matter. You're in the north, those crappie will bite. You just got to get out there and do what I'm going to do right here with that small little bladed bait on a small weed patch with rocks, and had the time of my life throwing that little bladed bait for a beautiful black crappie. Look at that rain. Wow, mamacita. What do you do in the springtime, man, when it's raining and it's windy and the water temperature's in the low 20s? Now you say to yourself, maybe you should fish real slow, you know, tubes, blow a float, try to find the fish. I'm gonna look for the most aggressive ones that potentially are thinking about going into spawn soon. So I'm gonna get out here. I got the power poles. So if I find the right fish, I got my marker boy, my sonars, a reliable rain suit, and I'm gonna try to find some crappie and show you how I do it so you can do it. Just focus that rod tip just above the water and a slow roll. That's it. Slow roll. When I think I'm going too slow, I gotta slow it down. All you want is that little blade just to turn. And that little shadpole CT, that little tail, that little back end, you know, even in the wind, it moves. You know what I mean? Even in the wind. Let's go. I'm gonna catch one right here, right now, right there. Watch this. He puts it out, engages the reel, picks up the slack line, slow roll. Let's find, another good one, Carl. Is it? Oh yeah, dude. Oh yeah. Yes, yes, please be big crappie. Look at this. Oh yeah, dudes. Whoa. I hope it's a big fat slab. I think it is, man. Is this what I'm looking for?
Carl, is it? It's staying down, man. Is it? Oh, yes, look at this. Oh, Lord, please, stay, stay, stay. Oh, yes. Hey? Oh, look at that, man. Oh, seriously, dudes, look at it. I'm going to show you where he's got him, too. Look at that. Look where he's got it. Look. Look at that. Just through the membrane. Did I tell you about that crappie wizard? B&M dudes. They are made for crappie fishermen by crappie fishermen, so you can catch them just like that. That's definitely going to be one of my picture fish. And she's ready to go. Look, see that? This fish, I'll show you. I'll let her go. But man, she's made my afternoon from rain, wind, cool. I don't care, man. You come out, you can catch them like this. It's just a weird sensation. And thank goodness, man, I'll tell you, the Crappie Wizard by B&M, it feels those real light bites, cork handle. It's just, it's awesome, man. It's a 7.6. I can put it out, cover water. Like, that's a real 1/8 ounce. Look how far I can put that out. Crappie fishing, camaraderie, having fun, and enjoying the resource, catching fish, cooking fish, and catching fish. Just, it's so addictive, man. If you haven't fished for crappie and you're watching the show, I know that you will get hooked because it is just psychotic. They gang up. They don't care how you fish for them, man. With a cane pole on the side of the road, with a cork, with little maggots. It doesn't matter where you fish, man. Anywhere in the United States, Ontario, Canada and stuff, crappie are addictive. Something about them. I love the fish, man. Let's catch a couple more and then we're gone. We'll say thank you for a fantastic afternoon. So you gotta get it right on, otherwise it's like not even casting. This spot, I gotta get it right out here again. There's some weeds out here that for whatever reason, they're producing some bigger fish. Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, I think I got it right where I needed to get it. That wind blew a bit, but let's see. There it goes. Slow roll. There's a good one. Yep. Oh boy. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh, this has got some weight, dude. This has got some weight. It's got some head shaking. I can see it in the water. Look at right here. Oh yeah, it's big, dude. Look. Look at this thing on the surface. Look. Oh my God, eh? Isn't that a nice crappie? Look at that. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Holy moly. Heaven to bitsy. Look at that. That's almost a net filler. Look at. Oh, Lord. Wow. Look at that. We got some in there that are even bigger and stuff. Just another good eater. But you know what? It's just making me happy. Crappie, you make me happy. Let's let you go, okay? Big, beautiful fish. Because another day I'm going to come out and I'm going to wish I catch fish like that. Whoa.
Wasn't that cool? Beautiful black and yellow, man. Something about those fish when they're near a weed, they're just gorgeous. On this next segment, I'm in the heart of Louisiana, down Monroe, Farmerville areas, okay, fishing with Tim again. And that was my first ever Crappie Masters tournament, what we did. We practiced, and man, did Tim ever find the fish. I give that guy all the credit in the world. He just knows how to find crappie and figure out ways to catch them. Man, I am just a co-pilot. When I see the rod go down, Tim is just like some of those other guys. They got the eye of the tiger. I got to watch my three or four poles. He's watching his, yet he still sees when mine go down. But I mean, you talk about hard fighting, cold water, big white slabs. Lake Darbonne and all those areas around Louisiana have some of the most fantastic big white crappie fishing you'll ever experience in your entire life. Check this out.
What you got, son?
Big crappie.
Big one?
Feels not bad. So hard to tell, eh? But I think he is good. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
How am I going to get him in?
Get that fish in the boat.
How am I going to get him in?
I'm going to show you.
Thanks, Tim.
Big
That's a good one.
Fat one there.
Hey.
Fat girl. What I thought.
Big bottom girl. Tim Blackley brings us up to this channel 30 feet of water, put the rods down about 20 feet, 25 feet, and we're catching suspended crappie, ones that are just a bit higher. Tim said those are the ones they usually are feeding.
All right, we're just out here fishing the flat. We're in round 9. We're staying between 9 and 7 foot. We're trying to catch some of these pre-spawn females that's coming up here to spawn, coming out of the channel. It's 9.6 feet deep, and you'll see there we just hit a stump with a trolling motor, and you see it on the depth finder. So, you know, that's a lot of places that the crappie stay. We're running about 0.3 or 0.4 on the speed, and water temperature is 55, which I've been here for 4 days, and it's gone down from 62 to 55.4. We've had a major cold front come in, which is typical for filming or doing a movie or tournament, so you always deal with that. But we've caught one big fish this morning, just now 8 o'clock, so feeling pretty good about this spot. Just going to carry on and see what else happens.
Pretty good.
Watch for a sec. Coming up over here.
Get out of the trolling motor, dude.
I don't know. Any good?
God. It's hard to tell when he's like that. God. It's amazing, man. On the tube again. That's a good one, dude.
We're out here trolling. We're in we're staying in about 25 foot of water. And one thing that we're keying on, we're staying right in the middle of this old river channel. And these fish are suspended out here in about 20 foot. We got our pole set at 20 foot deep. And I can just about tell every time we get a bite, we'll pull over one of these schools and I can see them on the depth finder. And we'll key on those. And once we get to them, we're trolling at about 0.2 or 3 most of the time. But once we get on top of one of these schools that I can see on the depth finder, we'll actually stop and just let all of our poles sit in it. And that's how we've got a lot of bites and caught a lot of fish. Good one?
Yep.
Where are you going with this?
Oh, get it. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
That's a hog, dude. That is a hog.
What do you think, black man?
That's a sick one.
Hey?
I'm dropping. That, my friends, is a 2 pound plus fish.
What do you think of that, folks, hey? What do you think of Darbone now, huh?
Didn't I hear those big whites would fight? Incredible, man. When they buried right down on those long spider rig poles, I mean, you didn't know. Catfish, drum, big, beautiful whites. On this next segment, I'm back in Ontario fishing on a weed flat with clumpy weed and a lot of big holes in water between 8 to 10, 12 feet of water. Again, it was a search and destroy kind of game plan. And I picked up the bright colored little crankbaits, and it was more figuring out the cadence than anything. I didn't just cast and reeled it in. It's about figuring out what these crappie wanted. They didn't want to chase. They got triggered by seeing the crankbait, the bright chartreuse and pinks, but they wouldn't commit if I did a constant cadence, reeling in, retrieve. I had to stop it, let the bait swim backwards, sometimes suspend, and then bang, they would smash it. Something about black crappie, when they get mean and they get tough, or when they get like a pound, pound and a half, they're incredible, man, because they put such a smack, it's like a largemouth or a big smallmouth smashing your crankbait. And you talk about fighting it, watch how these poles bend at some of these fish that hit right by the boat. But again, I had to just work on my cadence, figure out what they wanted at that time of the day to make a memorable afternoon catching big, beautiful black crappie in Northern Ontario. Check it out.
Okay, little crankbait crappies, huh? Let's see if we can get some. Crankbait crappie. Yes, sir. Oh, yeah. Crappie, look at that. First thing in the morning, huh? Oh, a big one, too. Holy God. What a way to start. What a way to start when you've actually got to pick up your net first thing because you're catching crappies with the little cranks. There's the start to my morning right there. A good eating size fish on the edge of a weed bed and stuff on some rocks. And I came out here looking about 15, 20 minutes, cast a crankbait around different spots on the weed and stuff. And I just saw a few little splashes. What that was is the fish were either feeding or chasing minnows. Let's put them in the box. Go on in there, boy. So what's the premise? The premise is we hope to catch some crankbait crappies first thing in the morning here in late May. And water temps are in the high 50s, almost 60. They're getting ready to spawn. But the thing is, not all the fish do the same thing at the same time. Different fish do different things at different times. And as for spawning and stuff, yeah, a lot of fish are going to go shallow. But a lot of fish are still going to stay on that offshore structure if you got rocks nearby and stuff, because they all don't just rush to the shoreline. If you got rocks and stuff and rock piles close to weed or main lake stuff, you know they're going to be there. I'm using a stop and go technique. What is this? I'm casting out, getting down about 3 feet, and then really slow rolling. Once in a while, it's just killing it. Dead. Stop. And those crappie cannot stand it. They're like bass. They see that crankbait go by their nose and then stop. And then it starts going backwards or moving sideways. It drives them nuts. Almost like fishing a little jerkbait or something. So cover some water, get it down, just stop it dead. Then jerk it again. Just make it do all different kinds of things. So they're not just looking at it going by the, you know, if you get a school turned on, that's no problem. You can just cast it, crank it in, that's fantastic. But I want to trigger bites with that little crankbait. So it just digs, stops, and when it stops, it goes up slow backwards and turns sideways and stuff. Just drives them crazy. Right back out here again. I'm on the edge of those weeds right here, right there. The drag just nice. And just slow roll and stop. But the thing is, you gotta get down right on top of those weeds and then stop it. Then go again, stop it. And as it's coming up, you know what's gonna happen. If you're anywhere near a crappie, he's gonna take a shot at it. And you just gotta hope that he's one of those big ones. Come on. Let's get a big one right in front of the boat. Oh yeah. You heard that, didn't you? You heard that. Oh, it's a good one too. We just finished saying, right? Get a big one in front of the boat. Look at this. Oh, come here, boy. Oh, yes. I must have been catching too many small ones because all of a sudden this looked like a big one. But this is just a nice, chunky crappie that would definitely make my meal this evening. Right here. Right there. Little crank comes out. Look at that. Perfect size eating crappies, man. Probably 12 inch. Nice. Look at the thick backs on that. Look at that. Look how thick. And that's exactly what they do when they inhale the crankbait. Their mouth just goes and they try to eat it. And they are. You're gonna join some of your buddies, right? Tonight you're gonna feed my family. Thank you. Going in there. How can you read it, man? Different techniques, presentations, baits. Crappie are so much fun. To me, they're so resemblance of bass fishing because you can use different rods and different presentations and different locations. And variety is the spice of life. And these crappies, whether they're black or white, it don't matter. I love them all because, man, they give me the same thrill with that heart rate that just goes do, 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 do. Let's make a cast this way. Cool way to fish, man. But it's so cool when you can see them. That's the wicked part. Slow, and I stop. I saw some nice big ones too, man. They came over and they try to eat it. Match how they want to eat it. Just stop and wait.
You see them come out of the weed? Attack it. So, oh my God. That's how the crappie should eat it. I stopped it, whack. And it's a big guy too, man. I see him fighting from here, look at this. How's that? That's a crankbait slab right there, boy. That's what I'm talking about right there. As soon as you stop it, you find the weeds. Guess what you find? Hello, Mr. Crappie's back. Let's get that at an angle like this here. Get that crankbait out. Where is it? That's the deal right there, hey? Look at that. Big, solid, thick, black crappie, hey? Look how long you are. You're probably 13, maybe 14 inch, man. I'm gonna put you in. I'm gonna take a few fish for my breakfast. Early morning crappie on a crankbait. How do you beat that, hey? Let's put this on. And it's just so cool. But it's about three things. Cadence, location, and patience. Patience to reel real slow, stop it, and wait. The bigger ones, the cadence, slow, stop, watch the bait go up. When the bait's farther and I can't see the bait, I just have a confidence knowing that somewhere that fish is going up. And three, having the right products like that rod where I can feel that dunk, that subtle bite or the violent little thing that you can feel all the way down to your wrist.
Catching big, beautiful black crappie on the cranks. How do you beat that? Maybe with this next segment you'll see. Fishing with legendary Mississippi guide, John Harrison. What a thrill it was, man. I get a chance to fish with some of the best crappie fishermen that ever picked up a jig pole on this earth. Trust me when I tell you that. Some of the guys, there's a lot of guys that I'll be fishing with in the near future again after this pandemic thing subsides a bit more, because this boy will be back in the deep south doing what I was born to do, and that is catch those big white crappie. On this segment, I'm fishing on a world-renowned Sardis Lake with John. He shows me how to use the B&M Caps and Coleman double minnow rig, how to find those crappie before spawn, before they go shallow, how they suspend on little lips and edges and stuff in deeper water, how he does it so you can do it. Because I learned from John, and I can't wait to get out again to fish with JH Guide Service, John Harrison, just like this.
All right. This is a double minnow rig. It was designed by Ronnie Capps, Steve Coleman. This is a 3/4, as you can see. Real easy and simple to tie on. Like that. And you got the perfect depth, length, weight, everything.
So it's almost like a drop shot rig, except you still got another hook at the bottom.
Right.
Right, okay.
Yep, that's a double minnow rig.
Okay. Pretty simple stuff, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
But deadly.
And it don't take but just a second to fix them up.
Yes. Right on. And the length of the rods today?
16 foot, BGJP. These are BGJP. They are Buck's graphite jig pole. They're not a trolling pole. They're not warranted for trolling, but they are tough.
Okay.
You know, we use them, and they come in all sizes. You can get them in 10s, 11s, 12s, 14s, 16s,
and all different models, 18s, depending 20. On what you're doing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. This right there.
There's one right there.
Look at that. Look at that. Right, he's setting it up.
He came right on the top hook, and he's about 2.5 feet deep there. Uh-oh.
That's catch and release.
Catch and release.
So, huh? What the bigger fish, you still do that? You still fight them all the way in and then grab it?
I just drag them up here.
All right.
Look here. Thank. Yeah.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Yeah.
Nice one, John.
Yep.
Nice slab. Nice one, man.
Yeah, look at that.
Oh yeah, you hold him up to him, he can build it. Good.
That's your good
nice
two-pound
one. Put him in the box for some pictures.
Yeah, the closer you get in, the warmer that water will be.
Yes.
The shallower you get
in. That's what they want, right?
That's right. And you could probably go in there now and catch some males. These females are staged back off out here in 7, 8, 9, 10 foot of water, just waiting to move in.
Right. So that's what we're fishing, staging females.
That's what we're catching right here, just staging up females out here.
Gotcha.
Get him. All right.
Oh, swinger, isn't he?
Yeah, swing him on. Up high.
I'm here, you. Oh, sort of swung him.
Sort of swung him.
A sort of swinger.
Sort of swingers.
Female, too, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just a little bit smaller, right? You think she's 12?
Oh, I'm pretty sure so.
Sardis Lake, man. White crappie. How do you beat it? And John doesn't use a net. He just grabs those things. You talk about this guy fishes 7 days a week, sometimes 3, 4, 5 months in a row. Is his hand or thumb on what's happening? You bet. And on the last segment here, I'm sure you're going to enjoy it because I pick up a variety of my 10, 11, and 12-foot B&M jig poles. If you haven't jig poled, you're missing out on a whole realm of catching crappie. I don't care where you fish, man. Big, beautiful whites, big, beautiful black crappie, especially in the North countries, man. Minnesota, Wisconsin, all across Quebec, Ontario, you name it. You're missing the boat if you don't pick up a jig pole, okay? I show you how to do it here. I learned from some of the best, and I have to transpire to share that with some good buddies that I fish with. You know, our little clique of guys, you know, we have a lot of fun, man, picking up when the fish move shallow. And on this segment, I did shoreline brush, fallen trees with the big, beautiful, obnoxious colored purple, pinks, therapists, mermaid greens, you name it. Crappie magnet makes the bait that you gotta look at, man. It's called the slab magnet. Something about that bigger profile, those big, beautiful, hard-fighting black slabs, can't get enough. And on this segment, you'll see why. I don't know which one to pick. I love the big, beautiful white crappie because for their sure size, they hold the rod down, bend the rod, and fight. Or is it the splish-splashy black crappies on single poles, little inline blade baits, or crankbaits? I don't know which one's better, but I do know this. You got to decide. Get out there, fish for those big whites, fish for the big blacks, and see which ones scrap harder. But on this segment, check it out, man. It's jig pole crappie time, one-on-one with a bigger bait, favorite jig pole, and these fish were schooled up and stacked like cordwood. Check it out.
Back in it. I like to have my finger right here on that pulse, my middle finger. I'm lowering the line and I can feel like lightning. Whack. Come on, where's the big one? Come on. Oh, another good one, eh? Look at that. Just a flip-floppy crappie. I think this one's gonna get let go. Oh, it's bigger than some of the ones we got. Man, man. I just catching so many cookie cutters. They all look the same. I know I'm going to have to go on the shorelines and look for some big, big ones. Let's see. I'm going to put them back over here. I'm fishing this tree. I'll let them go in this tree. Okay? You ready? You want to go in the tree? Go on. Go over there. Good boy. Then I come back over here. Pick up my pole. Check my jig, put that slab magnet back up there. It's repetitious over and over again, but catching fish is unreal. Put it right back in. Oh, wow. How many of you are in there? Hey, you know it when you're fishing crappies, boy. Something about picking up that pole and catching them one-on-one. It's unreal, man. And trust me, I love catching them with the float and crank and everything else. But boy, spider rigging is another fun thing. But man, when you're getting them one-on-one like that, it doesn't matter if they're 10 inches or 15 or monsters. It's feeling that rush of boom. And all of a sudden disappear your bait and it's crappie on. What a feeling. But using the right equipment, man, these long poles are a necessity for this. You gotta have it. You can just play around, move around. Look at that, I can move in the boat. Fish don't even see me either. Oh, there's two of them there. Oh boy. Come on, crappie. Wow. Oh, Lord. Pulled back. Look at that. Pulled my skirt down. Pulled the bait down. There was two of them there. Oh, getting smart now, eh? You know someone's here now, don't you? Do you? Can't be that smart. I'm just holding it a little higher. Sometimes I change color and that inspires more bites again. Here, this is why I changed different rods. Okay, this is my ultralight, and this one here is 11 footer. Now I've got a 10 footer with a Bucks graphite, and I got a 12 footer, but this close like this, they can get away with the 10 footer. Let's try it right here. Watch this. Pick that up. The 10 footer is the Bucks graphite jig pole. And again, slab magnet right there. Loosen that off a bit so I can pull some line about there. I tighten it up on the side. Find my positioning and I can put it right back because I'm fishing fairly close here with another one, black and chartreuse. Let's see if that fools some fish. Come on, boys. Get a few, see a few. Put it up right up in here, let's see. Pull the line down. They seem to be on this edge right here. Right on this edge of this right here. And we caught about five or six. Oh, there's another one right there. See that? Just by moving a little bit. That one's a fighter too. Look at him go. Okay. Is that a fighter? It is. Look at that. And I changed my color a bit too, eh? To the good old black and chartreuse with the 10 footer. So I can real close control, hand-to-hand combat, and being prepared. I got three poles like that. They're not a lot of money, but man, you can be absolutely prepared to fish for these crappies when you're doing the single poling one-on-one. And I mean sharp hooks, your little slab magnet, but having the right poles, it's you can do it, sure, with shorter rods and stuff, but you gotta get closer to the fish. Oh, that's a good one too. And you don't want them to see you. All you want them to see is that little bait you're shaking and then disappear. As for the poles right here, Bucks graphite jig pole, 10 footer. That's for the stuff that's real close to me. When I get those power poles right up tight to the cover, what I'm fishing and stuff, and I'm gonna fish almost vertically. I'm not gonna be pendulating them out, you know, like a pendulum out and let it swing and stuff like that. I want this exactly straight down from the end of the pole. So it's 10 feet long. And if I let out 10 feet, that gives me 20 feet of distance back from the crappie. The other option is my 11 foot ultralight. It is like they call it the in-between. So it's not the real close stuff. It's not the far reaching stuff, putting it in the holes and dropping it in and holding it there. But it's the ultralight 11 foot. Again, the slab magnet. And the piece de resistance, boys and girls, is my 12 footer, the ultralight. It's got the bottom reel here too, out of the way. It's got my black and chartreuse right there, slab magnet. But this one here, 12 feet long, and if I have the bait all the way down, that gives me another 12 feet. That's 24 feet of pendulum in the holes, dropping it in close, this side, that side. And you'll see a lot of times when I'm catching fish on the outsides and stuff, you want to move around a little bit. And sometimes they're just chasing the minnows or bait that's in that cover. So having that a little bit extra distance of the 12 footer give me 24 feet altogether all around, you can't beat it. Okay, it's deeper stuff, eh? Actually, the thicker branches come out. You just come out of the trees. Just like those paintings you see of crappie. Sitting in the brush. Oh boy. See that one? I didn't see. I just felt like lightning. And one of my bigger fish too. Look at that. Hey, smart thing.
Wow.
Smart crappie. I'm gonna call out some of them smaller ones for some of these. Because these are good eaters right here, boy. These are good eaters right here. Man, oh man, I love that. Wow, these hooks are sharp. Look at that. I got a bunch like that, so I'm let them go. Right here. Ready, crappie? Go on. Man, oh man. Variety is the spice of life. And when I can pick up a single pole, man, I don't care where it is, Mississippi, Tennessee, Illinois, all those crappie hotspots in the world, including Ontario, and catch crappies, I'm in heaven, man, I tell you. But boy, oh boy, you got to bring your long B&Ms, 10, 11, 12, depending what you're fishing. If you need a distance, sometimes the 10 footers are good if you're just fishing vertical right below you. But 11 to 12, and heavy brush, trees, that's the deal. This, I can drop it right in. Look at that. Wow. Right there. Oh, there's a big one. Oh, God. Oh, he turned. He's coming back. Oh, that's a good fish. Why is he so picky? Oh, boy. That's why he's picky, because he's got some girth. He's got some smarts, but he ain't that smart. Look at that. Look at that. Whoa, yes. Wow. I saw you turn, crappie. Polaroid glasses, boy. You gots to wear them, boy. Whether I'm bass fishing, crappie fishing, it don't matter to me. Wow. Wow. Look at them hooks. They are in, they stay in. Well, I got a few like that. You know what? Again, I got to catch them giants, man. Those are nice, but boy, they're not the giants. And we all love the giants, right? But how can you complain when you pick up your single pole and you're catching crappie after crappie after crappie by moving around? I love it. See if I can get one more here, huh? One more. One more. Can you make it? Is there one more here for me? I'm pretty sure there's one more, but we'd be impatient. Let's see. Shake it. Oh, yeah. Look at that one. Oh, boy. Will this one make it for me? Oh, yeah. Look at him. Wow. Wow. He's going to jump. Watch this. Going to jump? Come on. Make your tail go. Make your tail go. No? Okay, then. Oh, Lordy. These things are gorgeous. That's a good eater. Good eater. Look how far down he took it, too. Look at that. Slab magnet. My. By the same folks who make the crappie magnets. I tell you, they know how to make crappie baits, boy. Because crappie see it. Man, those crappie, they eat it. Sore lip them all, baby. Here's my colors of slab magnet. Black chartreuse. One of the most popular colors of crappie bait. I don't care where you buy baits, what kind of baits you use. This right here, the black natural with the chartreuse, everybody uses it. Another one right here called the therapist. I told you, I'm going to have some therapy today of crappie. This one's got that purple with little flake in there and the chartreuse little tail. That therapy, that's what I need right now. I need some crappie therapy. You going to work for me? You better. And last but not least, you ready? The mermaid. You just see that? A lot of times they call it blue with grass or different things, or like a bluegrass. But this right here, it's called the mermaid. Slab magnet right here. It's got that blue with some different peppered blue and metal flake. The chartreuse with some silver. That right there is killer in the water. I don't care if it's extra clear or extra dark, potentially depending on the different color, orange, chartreuse, or maybe pink jig heads. Don't worry about offsetting different colors because all of them will catch crappie on their mermaid. Whoa. Yeah, there's somebody home, huh? Look at that one, slap happy. Look at him. Oh, good one too, eh? Wow. Whoa. Look at that. Like a puppet master. That's a good one. That's a good one. Again, gotta use the pliers, man. Goes right through that top. It is in there, dudes. Wow, look at that. That's what you see when it's in the meat. When you say the metal meets the meat, that's it right there. See that? It's just a decent fish, but we'll let him go because we got lots. I'm looking for a monster, so I'm just gonna be a little picky. All right, at the end of my day here, or morning anyway, fishing with the single pole. I just gotta check that. I use the pliers there. Let's put it right back in, see if we can get your fish. Now you think about line, you know, you're fishing that pretty heavy cover. And these crappie here, maybe 2 pounders, but a lot of them are in that pound and a half, but it's the stuff they're in. They rub, as soon as you set, they go. They're like largemouth, you know, smallmouth, they just long runs and stuff like that. Walleyes too, shaking their heads and pike and different things. But these crappie, as soon as you hit them, all over the place, like a little wild pig, you know. So 6 pound gamma, you can either use fluorocarbon. I like the monofilament because the water's got some color, but the 6 pound has got so much strength and abrasion, so you're not constantly retying. But when you're fishing anything, any kind of species near trees, concrete, whether man-made or natural cover and stuff, always check that last couple feet like that, because you don't want to be heartbroken when you get the slab of the year and your line breaks. Bushes right here, tight. It's incredible where they sit. They like when the structure goes in the water like that. That's a good one. Look at that. You talk about splish splash, boy. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Oh, wow. Look at this one, how he ate it. Look at this one. He likes the pink bubble gum, doesn't he? Pink chartreuse. He's a handful. Wow. He's a good one. He's a good one. They're all good ones, aren't they? But he is. Yeah, he's a good eater. He's a good eater. Come here, boy. I need to put that there, because if I put it in the water, it'll probably get eaten. You need some therapy. You need to catch some big slabs. Have some fun. Pick up the B&M jig poles, the ultralight. But definitely, the slab magnet, by crappie magnet, they will give you the therapy that you need to catch crappie.
Okay, white crappie, black crappie, I don't know. You know what? They both fight the best, really. So is there a clear winner? You never know, man. It depends on the water temperature. It's in that cold water, you think that maybe they're not going to fight hard, and they pull like the devil. The black crappie splashing on the surface, something about it, man. They both are unique in their own right. But one thing is consistent. I love catching both of them. I know you do too. So if you get a chance to fish for white crappie, just go do it, man. You got a chance to fish for black crappie, you know, in the north, go do it. But one thing is consistent that I got to repeat. Those big, beautiful females that are ready to spawn, think about the future. Think about the next generation that experience what you do and what I do. Release for the future. Keep some for your meals. Everyone's right to do so. But think about catch and release, because I'm telling you, it works. And here's the deal. Just for watching our YouTube channel, and hopefully you subscribe, there's a chance to win this right here. I'm going to give away one of my favorite shirts that you've been asking about right here. The Xtreme Crappie Angler, black, short-sleeved, full logo on the back, in 2XL size. One person gets one. I think I'm going to give away something every video from now on. You know that? Seriously, your loyal subscribers, your comments, you watch it, I appreciate it. So for one of you, put a comment on the bottom of this video. Tell me why you like the video, why I should send you the shirt, and I will post this and show who won this shirt for posting on this video. You want one of the Xtreme Crappie shirts? All you got to do is subscribe, put a comment, and you qualify. Who wants it?
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. please subscribe. If you have any comments, look below in the description, put your comments, and yours truly will answer every question that you have, or statement, inquiry, whatever it is, man. I'm here for you to help you catch more and bigger crappie. Thanks for watching.